You're listening to Just Ask Malia with Malia Horde from the Malia Realty Group, recorded at Bourbon Barrel Podcasting Studios.
Hi, everybody. This is Malia Horde with the Just Ask Malia podcast series, where we connect the community to our local residents and future residents. And here at Malia Realty, we just love it. Love connecting you to the people that have become trusted businesses and affiliated partners with us. And today we have a very special company that has been dear and true to my heart, both personally and professionally. We have the Showplace at Lexington Winnelson. And today we have Rachel Smith and Kim McCullough. Hey, ladies, how are you?
Thank you for having us.
Oh my gosh, we're so excited. And, you know, of course, you know, Kim is near and dear to my heart and like a true sister. So I'm excited to share what you guys do and what you represent and how you help our community.
Well, we appreciate the opportunity to do that.
Well, thank you. So we love joining around our bourbon table, and I know you guys are remote, and I love that we have the ability with technology to bring people in, even if we can't physically sit together at the bourbon table.
Really? So we could be, I'm pretending right now that we are at the bourbon table.
You are at the bourbon table with us. But what I love about bringing people together is that through real estate, and living in this community for 21 years, I have connected to some invaluable businesses that not only contribute to the community and make it the best place to live, but also contribute to the people in the community by helping them do things around their house. So I believe behind every great business, not only are great people, but an incredible story. And I want you guys to share the story of the Lexington Winnelson business with all of us. So for those of you that don't know about the showroom at Lexington Winnelson, it has everything that you can possibly imagine for your fixtures and design trends for your kitchen, your bathroom, your outdoor kitchens. And I'm going to let these ladies explain how Winnelson got there because it is a franchise. So Rachel and Kim, tell us how the story of bringing the franchise to Lexington came about.
Malia, this is Rachel. And so I would like to tell you that I love to give my hat off to Kim because she's been doing this 17 years. I call her the queen of plumbing. I'm an aspiring princess at 6 years into doing this. And the reason we say that, especially, you know, in buying these beautiful old homes, they come with their challenges when it comes to plumbing. Plumbing is not easy. We find all the time that customers will say, oh, I'm just going to get my plumbing online. And that is not always the best idea. So our goal here at the Showplace at Lexington Winnelson is to really hold hands with our customers and walk them through the whole process. If it is a remodel, we want to say, okay, this is what you're starting with. This is what we think could happen or do in your specific place. This is what is on trend that's going to play along with it. And then overall, the biggest thing is how does that customer really use this space? So sometimes people will remodel their kitchens and they want these culinary looking kitchens, but they really don't plan to cook in them. Versus my next one might be a kitchen and they have 7 children. So we've got to be conscious about what kind of products are we putting in those types of areas. And I think Kim and I do that really well together as a team.
Well, and I totally agree with that. Kim and I worked very closely together with a downtown development. She was so educational for me to understand the latest trends, which we're going to get into, as well as how behind the scenes works, because I think a lot of people don't realize all the intricacies of things that go behind the walls or underneath the kitchen sink. So Kim was extremely patient, and she's a little fireball, aren't you, Kim?
Yes, I am.
A little spitfire.
Yes, I am. I try really hard. I say that plumbing's the hardest job I've ever had because there's a lot of pieces and parts that if you're not educated in the plumbing field, it can go really well or it can go really bad. And anything that I say water runs through, my rule of thumb is you need a professional.
Okay, Kim. So tell me, how did you even get into this industry? Because for those of you out there, you know, plumbing and dealing with plumbing fixtures and new construction is typically not a place for a woman. And I don't mean that in any regards of discriminatory or being sexist or whatnot, but you're feisty and you're really knowledgeable. How did you get into this industry?
How I got into the industry is I was in the medical field prior to my home in plumbing, and I just needed a change. I had done retail and sales in my younger years, and I enjoyed it. And I felt that this was a good home for me. This company is employee owned. We are a true family. We support each other individually and as a whole. And that speaks volumes for a company that, you know, we start from the beginning and we are friends and family by the end, even with our clients.
Well, and I think that's important too, especially with the way 2020 has evolved for all of us, family businesses and supporting those family businesses. Tell us about the Winnelson family.
Yeah. And, you know, the brick and mortar stores, you know, people take a lot of times for granted the knowledge, you know, 16 years, as Rachel said, 17, Rachel's been here 6 years. There's no price tag on that, especially when there's a problem.
And then really, people don't understand that it's translating what they want to do to a plumber that is maybe only able to see one vision and only knows how to put in one type of product. And maybe that client would like to have something that's a little out of the ordinary. So it's really our job to talk to them and help them through that process.
Okay, so let's talk about your products, because, you know, I've used you both on the commercial development side as well as my own personal home, which is under a mass remodeling of all of our bathrooms after we did our kitchen. So anything that revolves around the kitchen, the bathroom, an outdoor kitchen, what else? Am I missing anything?
There's dog washes. There's laundry spaces.
Water heaters.
Water heaters, outdoor showers, anything that water runs through.
Anything that water runs through.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen out there, think about that in your house as well as your business. Anything that water flows through is something that this company will handle on your behalf to provide. So let's talk about some of the trends that are going on. It seems that going through this pandemic of 2020 that we have going on, there has been a mass influx of remodeling as well as a mass influx of new construction going on. What are you seeing out there as the top five trends for people that are remodeling?
Well, one of the fun ones is that people are finally bringing back color. And so that's been a really interesting one, in which people will say, okay, well, what do you mean? How do you do color with your faucets and plumbing? Well, right now we're selling a lot of the gold. So several different gold colors, where it used to be people were trying to get gold out of their house. Now they want it back, right? So we have those satin brasses, beautiful polished golds that are different than any other gold out there. Polished nickel, matte black is huge right now as far as a finish. And then even something different than that, there is now, it's called polished black. And so polished black is like having your chrome finish, but with a black undertone. It is so spectacular, and it's going to be fun to watch what happens. So again, those colors on top of those countertops or against those tiles that are either got a design to them or they have different finishes in them, that's been really spectacular. So again, brights and contrast, we're seeing colors. Another trend that is huge right now is just wooden work. People are bringing the outdoors in. We're finding that we're in our homes all the time. So I say this often, is that any little element that you can bring in, as far as there's handles on faucets that have teak wood, there are teak benches and teak trays that go over bathtubs. They're in the countertops and kitchens areas, they're doing cutting boards that are just bringing in that little piece of wood element, which is really fun.
I'm just telling you, I'm getting my bench in my shower. So when you say that, it makes me really excited.
Yay.
I want to go back to the colors before we go to number three trend, okay. The colors. So as a real estate agent, I am always going through these homes from every price point and people saying, oh, it has gold, it looks old. And now you're telling us that gold's coming back. And I remember, Kim, when we started with the development, you were saying brush gold, and we put that brush gold in our model and it was like,
spectacular.
It was absolutely spectacular. It was a total wow. People walked in and just said, never would have thought of that. That is beautiful. You were ahead of the times before all of us in Lexington, which was fantastic. But people are still going back to that matte silver and the oil bronze, which were the big rage probably 5-6 years ago. Where did those two fall?
So I'm gonna say something, and I say this in my showroom. We are creatures of habit. We get fixated on what the past is. It's no different than going from a flip phone to an iPhone. Everybody thought, oh my goodness, I can't do it. I can't do it. I can't do it. It's like riding a bike. Once you do it once, you're good. When you change up your different finishes, and that's, you know, Rachel and I, we kind of, to see it, to believe it is how we kind of show people. We take inspiration pictures from projects that we've done just to be able to share our experience and our knowledge with a client that is here and is not visual.
Yeah.
And that helps a lot.
That's very true. You do paint that picture very well for us.
Yeah.
Okay. So we have colors. We have implementing wood. What's the third trend?
So a lot of it is the technology that's out there. So something that's happening right now is, I'll give you one example. Moen, U by Moen, has a push button control pad that will turn your shower on and off for a 1- and 2-person memory. There are features in that that will allow you to flow 4 different items in that shower. So a rain head, shower head, body sprays, and a handheld. So all 4 things, they can either come on at once or come on in different ways at different temperatures. You can control that by your phone. So by using Alexa or Google, you are able to turn on these showers. That brings me to steam showers. We've never sold so many steam showers ever till now. But again, that's a reflection of people are staying home instead of them traveling to spas and all of these different places. They're creating the spas in their homes. So it's been an exciting year for us in plumbing because of that. And they're just investing a little bit more. So technology is also used in the kitchen and in the bathrooms, and that is where you can touch your faucets on and off with a simple touch of the back of your hand or your elbow. And then the next thing that's around the corner is voice technology, where I can literally say by using Alexa and my faucet, I will be able to say, faucet, pour me a cup of cold water. Faucet, pour me a cup of hot water. Or you can say the temperature. You could say whatever it needs to be.
Wow.
And there's times in our kitchen, it cracks me up. Like, I didn't really think I would use it, but I was saying sometimes you walk away from the faucet and you can say faucet off and it will turn itself off. And I do that often in my own kitchen where I'm like, oh, I forgot to turn that off. It would be so nice to just say faucet off.
Well, I got to tell you, you're so right with this technology because, as you know, Kim and Rachel, we are remodeling 4 bathrooms in my house, and we put that technology in our fan above the showers where it has a glow light, a night light, and it has 3 different dimmers on it, and it plays music, and that is the ultimate bomb because in the morning, my husband listens to music and I listen to a podcast while I'm taking a shower. And it has totally changed my day in the morning, just starting me off on a great mood. We have music blasting throughout our house in every room now. And I tell you what, I mean, it makes that small little change makes me happy. Yes, it does. Yes. It makes me very happy. So much so that the workers and the owner of the contractor business have all gone out and bought that as well for their homes.
I want one.
Yeah, they want one. It's contagious. Okay, so colors, wood, technology. What's number 4?
So I would say the tubs would be another big feature.
Yes.
So let's talk about tubs. We get asked every day, do you think I should go back with your whirlpool tub that we have now? Like, we're getting rid of it. We're taking it out of our house. Do we go back with it for resale value? What's the most important? So I
respond back that a Whirlpool tub is good if you use it. And that's the biggest thing, is a lot of people will put in Whirlpool tubs and they just sit there. So we highly recommend air baths over Whirlpools for the simple fact that they don't have water that runs through the tub. And the freestanding tubs over drop-ins, the freestanding is a trend that is continuing on. They're continually updating all the faucets that fill those tubs. So either out of a wall or a freestanding faucet or a tub that can accommodate a faucet that sits right on top of it. There's just so many different things within that category of tubs.
Well, and I'll bring this back to what I see with the discriminatory buyers when we do house tours. I'm finding that the clientele is really going towards that drop-in tub without the jets, as well as the freestanding tubs. I think the women love that freestanding tub where they can have that perfect bubble bath, quiet time. It's all me. If they feel very enclosed. In the jets, people are finding with hygiene that they prefer that freestanding, and there's ways that you guys can incorporate the bubbles without the jets. Is that correct?
Yes, exactly.
Okay. So we have the tubs. What's number five?
I would just say, let's just talk about what's happening in our kitchens. Our kitchens are really becoming the center of your house, your party. Everything is happening in there. So people are expanding, right, their kitchens and making them more open spaces. And so with that, we want these kitchen sinks to be more of workstations. So that is a big trend right now. People are saying, what can we do to make this happen where you can have different layers of grids and rollback grids or cutting boards that are in and out of them? They're getting a little bit bigger. So we're really stretching that. Back in the day, sinks were not that big. And now we are taking every ounce of that inch of space from a 36-inch cabinet, or even asking our cabinet designers to go up to a 39-inch or a 42-inch cabinet base to accommodate bigger sinks.
You're right. And I'm finding that the discriminatory buyer really wants the kitchen. You're right. The kitchen is the center focus. But they want that kitchen to have that island with the sink where people can come around it and it be very functional and open to the house. We always say the kitchen, the master bedroom, and the master bathroom are the most important, with the kitchen being the number one selling point of the entire house.
Absolutely. Yes.
100%.
And then I always remind people that with these open spaces, that means you have to be a lot cleaner, right? Because everybody's entering into your kitchen and your space. So one of my favorite things is to take a laundry room and make sure that laundry room has basically a shake center or someplace that you can mess up. So maybe it's a pantry that has a little butler sink in there. But I love those spaces that you can create a small place to maybe not be so clean, like making a shake every morning or a coffee bar or a coffee bar. Yeah.
Tell me, what is the most unusual trend you've seen? Like, you talked about dog baths. I'm seeing a lot more of that, especially in our luxury homes where there's an area specifically for the dogs to take their bath.
Yep, absolutely. Unusual, but definitely needed. Yes. And a luxury. I mean, that's a luxury that a lot of us with big puppy dogs, we would give anything to have.
True. What about farmer sinks? Farmer sinks, ceramic sinks. You guys have any preference?
Mm-hmm. The apron front sinks. So definitely apron front sinks are still on the top of the trend, and they have been now for a few years. And we're finding them in different materials. So something that's been really fun is LK just came out with a apron front sink. So it's stainless steel inside, but it has 8 different panels on the front of it. So you can choose between white or red or navy or black stainless. So you can do these different cool finishes and even change them out depending on what happens for you. And I love it because in the event they would get damaged, you would have another option or a way to fix them.
Very true. And believe it or not, you don't really think about all of the options of a sink until you actually have to pick one out. I know that we went back and forth between a square sink and like curved angles. And do you want stainless or do you want ceramic or do you want granite? The list is endless. And again, that's where you guys become so incredibly helpful and resourceful for people, is that you give the ideas, you give the information so our clients can make a great informed decision. So tell me, what are some of the important things that if someone's about to start a renovation or a remodel, what are some of the things that they should think about or consider before they start?
Have a contractor, have a plumber, have a game plan, have a theory idea, and a support team.
Okay, so a support team. What do you mean by that, Kim? What would you
recommend? Support team. You need to, it takes an army.
It does.
To create a great space. So you need a contractor, B, a great plumber, C, somebody that's going to help you design and make the space your own and know your personality and what you're wanting within your space, and have expertise as far as plumbing, lighting, flooring, have a team of people be on board to create your space to be fabulous.
That's right. And, you know, I think it also helps because when you're doing all that to form your budget, I've waited 20 years to get my master bathroom, and it was totally worth it because it's much more encumbersome than what people think, between the rough-in plumbing that you have to do or tweak, as well as the exterior plumbing that you actually see. The rough-in plumbing is far more
correct.
Extensive than the actual shower head that you can screw on at the very end, right, Kim?
Yes, and you want it all to work together. You know, some companies do shower system, tile systems different. There are different lifetime warranty shower systems out there that, you know, we would talk to the client about, as well as paneled showers that have zero grout line if you want no maintenance. There's also shower bases that you could put down and tile the walls. I mean, there's just endless opportunities and options out there. Meeting and greeting and just kind of filling the person out and seeing what their option is and what they want out of their project is the funnest part of our job.
Oh, yeah. So how do they find you? How do they, you know, you guys are, I feel you are a great place to start because you have so many great ideas. And although you're only on the plumbing kind of fixture end of things, I think you're very encumbersome about explaining the process and what comes next. So how do they find you?
Finding us is the biggest thing yet. Again, we love appointments. We love that you're going to come in and tell us when you're coming. Let us get you in our schedule. That is the most important thing right now. And we are located off the old drag strip in Nicholasville.
Right across the street from Sam's.
Well, kind of.
Yes, yeah.
Stoplight before Sam's. Stoplight before Sam's. Yes. So we are next to Aladdin's Glass. Our address is 211 Industry Parkway. And people drive by us all the time and they don't see us because we sit up on that high, high hill and it says the Showplace out front. But again, if people could call before coming out, that would be best, because then you're going to either have Kim or myself, Rachel, our undivided attention. And we stay extremely busy,
and which is great.
And due to COVID, you know, we do have the restrictions that we all hate, but it actually creates a better working environment for us, for our clients, because they truly have our undivided attention. And we have found that it works better. We hate to say it. We like it, but we wish it could stay. It's been great.
Well, and your showroom is absolutely beautiful. It's so overwhelming. I think every time I come in there, Kim, you shoo me away from things because it's all the bells and whistles. And of course, my mom used to say if there was a $100 shirt and a $10 shirt and they both looked exactly the same, I would pick up the $100 one. And every time
Malia,
I go,
I call that a talent. That's a talent that us females have.
Yes. Yeah.
And everyone that walks in here, they do the same thing. But we have, and I'm glad that you pointed that out, We have price points for every budget. So
just please keep that in mind.
You do, and you're so patient. We've had some clients that we have sent your way that have been extremely hand-holding, and we have other clients that know exactly what they want, and you're straight to the point and right to the bottom line for them. But you carry, tell about the different product lines that you carry, because a lot of people just think Delta, and you are extremely expansive in your product line.
Yeah. So Delta also has their luxury line Brisa, which we sell a lot of here in our location and have a lot of beautiful samples. We have Toto. So that's along the lines for tubs, toilets, and faucetry as well. And Vilroy and Bach, we have American Standard, their luxury line called DXV. Their product right now, Kim and I can't say enough about them. We love American Standard to the end. Growy, we have an incredible display of that brand. And then, of course, Moen, which Moen has been a backbone in the plumbing industry for many years. And that's just a few.
Now, I know that Growen, DVX, Moen, Kim, I was just in there yesterday picking up our plumbing fixtures, and I saw one of each brand that I absolutely loved, and you shooed me away.
Well, that's just because you had Delta valves in the wall. I love you.
Okay, so we haven't talked about something that I think is a little more personal, but toilets.
There's as many toilets to pick from as there are faucets, and it's really personal preference on what a client is requesting. The flushing technology is going to be the biggest thing. Unfortunately, California code is implementing less water per flush, which has made the toilet industry's companies step up their flushing mechanisms. And unfortunately, people have different views on what they want out of a toilet. And I'll just give you a couple examples. Some people want a clean look, meaning a one-piece skirted where you don't see all the piping. Some people want an entry level from that has a 3-inch flush valve that, you know, will take 1,200 grams down. There are decorative, very traditional and contemporary. There's wall hung with actuators. The list goes on.
So just to recap some of the products that you guys carry, you carry toilets, sinks, faucets, tubs, water heaters, medicine cabinets, those LED mirrors,
yes.
Right? The standalone tubs, the saunas. Have we missed anything? Because I think a lot of us out there in the general public that don't work in the industry don't realize that you're kind of like a great one-stop shopping for all budgets, for all personalities, for all styles and decor. Not only do you deal with the actual builders and contractors on the back end, but you deal with the consumer on the front end.
That's correct.
Okay.
And if we don't have it, we probably have a suggestion of where you can and a contact person. So that's unique to our industry. You know, we're all trying to accomplish the same thing and we all work together. So if we don't have it, we may be able to give you a great option of where to get it and who to talk to.
And I want to tell everybody out there, the housing industry right now is at an all-time historical high, and the remodeling and the renovation is at an all-time historical high. When you guys meet these two ladies, you will be in complete awe. They run 300 miles per hour all day long. They are there at night. They're there on the weekends. They are so accommodating to their clientele. I cannot say enough good things about you guys and how much I value your expertise and your guidance, you know, both for myself personally with my family, as well as for my clients. And I just want to let you guys know how grateful I am and let people know that I personally would recommend you all day long.
Malia, thank you so much. We value you, and we consider everyone that we work with at the end of the project family. And we've always had that stance, and we always will.
Well, I appreciate you guys so much. I appreciate you guys taking out of your time. I know I took your lunch break up, and for all of you out there, I highly recommend that you get in touch with them. So ladies, tell us your phone number, the best number to reach you guys.
Our phone number is 859-887-9759.
Okay, that's 859-887-9759. It is the Showplace by Lexington Winnelson. They're at 211 Industry Parkway. We're going to have all of that on our website. We'll have that on all of our social media outlets and feeds, as well as in our newsletter that's coming out to spotlight you guys. And please go in, introduce yourself, meet Rachel and Kim. Kim is my pint-sized twin, so I love that. One day I'm going to steal her over to real estate, but don't tell your boss.
Right.
And if you guys have any questions, they are definitely your go-to person. Ladies, I appreciate you so, so much for your time and expertise.
Thank you so much.
Yes. So for all of you out there, if you have any plumbing needs or remodeling needs, feel free to reach out to these ladies. And as always, when you're ready to buy, sell, build, or invest, I'm your girl, Just Ask Malia. Well, that wraps up another great podcast. Thank you so much for joining us at the Just Ask Malia podcast series. It's always a pleasure to help the local and future residents of Kentucky make smart real estate decisions. And we love connecting you to our community. And that's why we do this. So be sure to subscribe to our podcast series. Make sure your friends and family know all about it. Tag, like us, find us on Facebook, social media. And remember, when you're ready to buy, sell, build, or invest, I'm your girl, Just Ask Malia.